SmackDown. And coming up next, Kane will explain his side of the story for what has happened between the relationship of The Undertaker and Kane. It's next.
When the devil removed himself from heaven and earth, he left behind seven deadly sins. Of these seven, my favorite is, and now always will be, the sin of pride. You see, big brother, it was your pride that weakened your powers over your decades of destruction. It was your pride that allowed me to put you in a vegetative state. Because of your pride, I knew that you would come back before you were ready. And ultimately, because of your pride, I was able to drop you on your head at SummerSlam. Do you remember when it all began? Do you remember how your downward spiral, your journey from immortality to that mangled wreck that I left in this ring this past Sunday? Do you remember how it started, brother? For years, I was nothing more than just some vague memory in the back of your mind. But when you saw me again for the first time, the look in your eyes told the story. It was the story of an older, self-serving brother who was obsessed with the pride of keeping the spotlight all to himself and keeping me in his shadow forever. Everything that I did in those early years, you were able to overcome. Instead of destroying your legend, I made it greater. When you set me on fire, I knew that it was my influence that pushed the dark side to the limit. It took your little brother to separate you from your last vestiges of humanity. It was your most magnificent moment. That's when I knew what I had to do. That's when my master plan was set in motion. With every victory, your collection of souls grew, and so too did your weakness. So I watched, and I waited. And even in victory, it was clear that you were losing your grip. But the day that you forced me to remove my mask and show the world my true face was the day that you unleashed the monster capable of finally ending your reign of darkness. When we met for the second time on the grandest stage of them all, the time was not right. But the plan continued to evolve. You see, I know you better than anyone, brother. I positioned myself at your right hand so I could gain your confidence And even then, I watched and I waited. You see, our reunion, it was nothing more than a vehicle for my vengeance. I knew no matter how many times you were sent crashing down, you'd always get back up. Your pride forced you to get back up. But your pride would be your undoing. You see, while you were disgracing yourself, while you were allowing yourself to be disgraced by those beneath you, I was biding my time. And I knew that my time had finally come. The moment that you showed Shawn Michaels an instant of mercy. You had a choice. You could destroy Shawn Michaels. Or you could become one with your weakness. It was your decision that sealed your fate. Because I knew at that moment that the plan that I had hatched over a decade ago had finally come to fruition. I knew last Sunday when I saw that shadow of your former self rise up out of that coffin, when I felt your weak grip on my throat, I knew that it was over. All the years of plotting, all the years of planning, all the years of waiting, all the years of watching in the shadows were finally at an end. I had my vengeance. Had eluded me for so long. And now, brother, the shadows in which I once labored, they're cast upon you. And what was once your holy grail is now my world heavyweight championship. Undertaker, we used to be called the Brothers of Destruction. But now, you are nothing more than the brother that I destroyed. For 15 years, I dreamed of the day when the Phenom would be no more. For 15 years, I relished the thought of being the dominant brother. For 15 years, I knew that this day would come. I have dedicated my life to making this moment reality. The moment when my brother would be cast down with great vengeance and furious anger. And I would replace him as the devil's favorite demon.
Thank you.
emerge from his brother's shadow, but at what price? What consequences await the Big Red Monster? Will his own poison-filled heart soon rest in peace?